work?
Yeah, so far it's good. Like usually I have 2 days to set up, like usually 1 day.
Yeah.
And this time I had 4 days, so it's more than what I need to set up. So.
Yeah.
And it's a long space, as you can see. Like it's a long gallery, so it's not easy to make sure that everything works properly. So when I came in December, I came just like 1 hour to meet François, the owner of the gallery.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a show here, so and a very different kind of work. So it was a bit, you know, to imagine the space empty and to see your work, to imagine your work. So I went back to Europe and tried to organize this out and arrived 4 days ago and put all the works pretty much on the floor to see how it could work and things like that. And so far, I'm very happy with what's going on. So
wicked.
Yeah.
Wicked.
So, but the opening is tomorrow night.
So depending on the space, you have to figure out how you're going to curate. I mean,
yeah, because I used to be an architect before.
Okay.
So I like to also use the space to show my work. You know, I don't just come and hang the work and that's it. I like to use the space as part of the of an installation.
Gotcha.
So I always put my work as in more like an installation than just like a proper show. And so that's why you can see on the wall here. So
yeah, I love this. What is this?
Well, all the this show is about the story of a Japanese cannibal,
okay,
who ate a young Dutch lady in Paris in 1981. And after he killed the lady, he ate her during 2 days. And after 2 days, he wanted to drop all the leftover of the body in a small lake near Paris, in the neighborhood of Paris. And the neighborhood is full of prostitutes. So the prostitute saw that guy coming every night, throwing away bags with meat inside. And so they called the cops. And they went into his apartment and they found like a complete like massacre.
Get out of here! Oh my God!
So he got caught and he never denied. Like he always said that he wanted to eat a woman and he came to France for that because he knew that he may not go to jail but to go to psychiatric hospital.
But so he thought he knew he'd go to a psychiatric hospital if he does it in France, but
yes,
it's another country.
Yes, true.
Oh my God.
True. So, but his dad was like a big businessman in Japan, so he got him the best lawyers, and after 6 months, he got extradited to Japan. And when he arrived in Japan, there was a kind of a misunderstanding in between the Japanese law and the French law. So there was a mistake, you know.
Yeah, lost in translation?
In the procedure, there was a kind of a mistake, so the lawyers in Japan used it, and after 6 months or 1 year in Japan, he got freed.
Wow!
So he did a year and a half in jail, in custody, mostly, waiting for his trial, and then got freed. And in Japan, there are they do not recognize mental sickness, so he doesn't have any following up with a psychiatric or something like that. So he's completely free. So he's still living in Tokyo, and he's completely free. And because there are not so many cannibals, you know, in the world, it's not like often, you know, like on a crime.
Yeah, I read something the other day, some cannibalism going on in Europe or whatever. You don't hear about it.
No, so there was a lot of press about this story.
What year was this?
81.
81.
81. So there was a lot of press. So when he arrived in Japan, he became a kind of a small celebrity. And he started being invited to TV shows. He became a food critic for a Japanese food magazine.
Became a food critic?
Yeah. And he became a mascot for a TV ad for a meat chain restaurant and also a small porn star actor.
Wow.
And he still does that. And he always, you know, like he did a lot of press interviews where he explained exactly how he killed the body, how he ate the lady and things like that. And he also explained that for him, eating human flesh, like from a young girl, is the ultimate stage of making love. Because also in Japanese, like the way you say to make love, so the way they say that, there's a Japanese character and the Japanese, the kanji is meat.
Meat.
So for them, the relationship to sex is more like, you know, to eat than more sentimental. They could be in Europe or anywhere else. So this guy is completely free and lives in Tokyo just like this. So that's why I did this entire work about this story, because for me, it's how to portray sex and violence in art. So it's not only about a matter of how strong the images could be, it's more about the story behind it. So I took photograph of, I created a link in between Japan and France. So I took photograph of butcher window displays,
yeah,
raw meat, and I took photographs of porn, movie, cinema, window display in Tokyo. And I put them together. And so you have like the meat photograph are nothing weird. It's just meat. And the window display of the movie cinema in Tokyo, or the porn movie cinema, is just erotic images, so it's not so, you know,
obvious. Yeah.
But when you put them together to explain that story, then it became something very...
Oh, yeah.
When you look at it and you know that it's related to this story, then it became very strange. So what I wanted to do is very simple, is I wanted to show the real story and my interpretation as an artist. So I use the gallery as a long space,
mm-hmm.
and on both sides, I share the gallery in two.
Gotcha.
So on this side, it's an historical wall.
So it was, historical?
Yeah, it's all these images that have been in the press
mm-hmm.
When they talked about that story. So they are all real images. So you can see the guy in the street of Tokyo. Like here, it's all about him when he was a kid, his parents. And here, this is his apartment in Tokyo right now. So I put a map of Tokyo and a map of Paris here. And all here, it's all about, you know, when he got arrested. You can see him with the French police, evidence in the apartment, the photograph of the apartment.
That's amazing.
Photograph of the trial, the recording of the policeman, and the leftover of the body and his apartment in Paris. The suitcase where he put the body parts before throwing them in the lake. So it's, and I created a matrix about with the red thread about it all happened in those two places. It's before
yeah.
he did it, so it's how weird it was and how now he has like this very you know, his life in Tokyo is completely free. So that's
wow.
I don't need to explain the story.
Yeah.
The entire story is just right here visually. And on the other side of the gallery, it's my artist interpretation.
What have you learned from this? I mean, like, you weren't studying, or you weren't really fully aware of capitalism before. I was curious as to
the voyage. About this. It's more about, I've seen a lot of artists using sex in art or violence in art. And it's always been a recurrent, you know, theme in art, sex and violence. So I tried to see how I could do that using the way I do photography. So I just took that story and saw what I could do about it.
Yeah, amazing.
So here you have the pieces where it's raw meat and erotic images from the porn movie cinema window display in Tokyo.
Hmm.
And all the text here, it's always halfway in between food and sex.
I love it.
So that's a work in progress.
Yeah.
Still in progress for tomorrow night, as you can see.
This is amazing. I had no idea. So tomorrow, what time?
6 p.m.
Tomorrow, 6 p.m.
6 p.m., yeah, so wake up early, brush your teeth, and come over.
Definitely. Thank you so much. Wake